Para tamu undangan yang kami hormati, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin. Pada hari ini, Selasa 1 Desember 2020, Program Studi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa S3 Pasca Sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang mengajukan Saudara Joko Sutrisno, MPD, SPD MPD sebagai promovendus untuk dapat diujikan disertasinya yang berjudul Encircling Critical Reading Throughout Digital Literature Circle and Technology Integrated Instruction Technique to Student with High Intermediate and Low Critical Language Awareness Levels. Saya laporkan kepada Bapak Rektor bahwa Promovendus telah menyelesaikan semua perkuliahan serta telah menjalani beberapa tahapan pengujian disertasi sebelumnya di Pasca Sarjana UNES dan kesemuanya dinyatakan lulus serta telah memenuhi syarat untuk ujian disertasi tahap kedua ini. Oleh karena itu, saya mohon Bapak Rektor selaku Ketua Penguji untuk membuka dan sekaligus memimpin ujian disertasi secara resmi. Akhirul kalam, wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saudara Promovendus,
siap, Prof.
Saat ini Bapak Rektor sedang ada acara yang tidak mungkin ditinggalkan. Beliau tadi menugaskan saya untuk mewakili beliau untuk membuka sekaligus memimpin ujian ini. Apakah saudara bersedia ujian ini saya pimpin?
Bersedia, Prof.
Baik, terima kasih. Sebelum ujian ini saya buka, saya bertanya dulu kepada saudara, apakah saudara dalam keadaan sehat?
Insya Allah sehat, Prof. Alhamdulillah.
Ya, alhamdulillah sehat. Apakah benar karya yang nanti saudara pertahankan adalah karya asli saudara sendiri?
Asli karya saya sendiri, Prof.
Baik, silakan baca dan tanda tangani surat pernyataan keaslian.
Pernyataan keaslian. Dengan ini saya, nama Joko Sutrisno, nomor induk mahasiswa 02016107, program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa Inggris, menyatakan bahwa yang tertulis dalam disertasi yang berjudul Enhancing Critical Reading Through Digital Literature Circle and Technology Integrated Instruction Technique to the student with high intermediate and low critical language awareness level. Ini adalah benar-benar karya saya sendiri, bukan jiplakan dari karya orang lain atau pengutipan dengan cara-cara yang tidak sesuai dengan etika ilmu keilmuan yang berlaku, baik sebagian ataupun seluruhnya. Pendapat atau temuan orang lain ini yang terdapat dalam disertasi ini dikutip atau dirujuk berdasarkan kode etik ilmiah. Atas pernyataan ini, saya secara pribadi siap menanggung risiko ataupun sanksi hukum yang dijatuhkan apabila ditemukan adanya pelanggaran terhadap etika keilmuan dalam karya ini. Semarang 1 Desember 2020 yang menyatakan saya Joko Sutrisno.
Tanda tangani silakan.
Baik, Prof.
Tunjukkan ke kami. Ya, baik. Ya, cukup. Saudara sudah siap untuk diuji ya?
Insya Allah, Prof. Siap.
Baik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan Saudara Joko Sutrisno, SPD, MPD, secara resmi saya nyatakan dibuka. Selanjutnya, saya perkenalkan tim penguji negara Puan, Profesor Dr. Fathur Rahman Imbum, anggota sekretaris Profesor Dr. Agus Minatin Imbum, anggota satu Profesor Dr. Soekarno MSI. Matur nuwun Prof. Karno. Dua, Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono MPD bagi penguji dua. Tiga, Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto MHUM sebagai penguji tiga. Empat, Sri Wuli Fitriati SPD MPD PhD penguji empat. Lima, Dr. Dwi Anggani LB MPD penguji lima. Enam, Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD penguji enam. Selanjutnya dipersilakan Saudara Promo Vendus untuk berdoa lebih dahulu. Baik. Selanjutnya dipersilakan Saudara paparkan karya Saudara. Maksimal waktunya 15 menit. Persilakan.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Mohon izin sholat dulu sebentar.
Good afternoon. The Honorable Rector Universitas Negeri Semarang, The Honorable Director of Program Pasca Sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, The Honorable Examiners, and also the respected audience. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much for this opportunity that today I could present my dissertation with the title Enhancing Critical Reading Through Digital Literature Circle and the Technology Integrated Instruction Technique to the Student with High, Intermediate, and Low Critical Language Awareness Levels. Today, I will divide my presentation into several parts, including introduction, and then research question, and then research methodology, finding, discussion, and also conclusion and suggestion. Based off the background of the study, it was an effort to achieve national education objective expand to the student to be men who believe in fear of God the Almighty, noble and gracious, healthy, knowledgeable, creative, independent, and into citizen democratic and responsible. I cite from Undang-Undang Nomor 20 Tahun 2003 tentang Pendidikan Nasional. And then the second one is the implementation of 2013 curriculum or K-13 that student must have four competencies. The first one is critical thinking and problem solving skill. And then the second one is communication skill. And then the third is creativity and innovation of collaboration. I also some the background that many teachers believe that skillful thinking is the one of the essential objective in education. Modern societies have need people to possess not only remarkable knowledge, but also strong reading skills, often referred to as a critical reading or higher order thinking skill. I cite from Bloom taxonomy. And then the fourth one is one of most of important university student skill in EFL is reading academic text. In EFL university student, much of reading instruction tend to concentrate on the processing, tech of processing, understanding, and criticism of language of the text by the readers. And then I see from the information that the Industrial Revolution 4.0 is basing the universe in which digital technology with increasingly involved in the dynamic of global setting and how it impacts education and science. Here I cite from some information that based on the figure here that 74% teachers believe that technology enabled them to reinforce and expand their content. And then 60% of high school senior and college students believe that the technology helped them study more efficiently and perform better in class. And then 93% teachers agree that digital resources help their student academic achievement. And then 50% of teachers agree that digital resources engage their student in learning. Well, based on the study, based on my study on the background that I took three variables on the factor in my dissertation. The first one is critical reading skill represented by digital literature circle and technology in the creative interaction. Why I took these two techniques because both of them are considered as an effective teaching technique. And then a second variable is critical language awareness as considered to design developing student critical language awareness through explicit teaching methodology of some procedure of critical discourse analysis. Here, I represented the CLA by using the high, intermediate, and low CLA level. And then to make problem become clearer, I take into 13 research questions. The first one is, how significant is the use of DLC in teaching critical reading toward students who have different critical language awareness in the between pre-test and post-test? And then second one is toward the student who have high and intermediate in the CLA and the post-test. And then the third one is toward to the student who have high and low critical language awareness in the post-test. And then the fourth is intermediate and low CLA in the post-test. And then the fifth research question is, how significant is the use technology in the graded instruction technique in teaching critical reading towards students who have CLA level between pre-test and post-test? And then the second is towards to the student high and intermediate CLA in the post-test. And then the seventh, high toward the student who have high and low CLA in the post-test. And then X towards students who have intermediate and low CLA in the post-test. And then the ninth research question is, how significant of using DLC or using DRI in teaching critical reading towards students who have high in CLA level, and then the 10 toward who have intermediate in the CLA level, and then the 10 toward students who have low CLA level. And then the 11th research question is, which technique gives significant influences in teaching critical reading using DLC or using EI on the different student critical language awareness level? And then the last research question is, how significant is the interaction among the technique of using DLC, the EI, and high, intermediate, and low of CLA level in teaching critical reading? Before conducting this research, I browsed some previous studies related of the topic that has been conducted by several researchers as in the more than 100 journal articles or thesis or dissertation. I take this theory from this previous study from the first is from Brick 2010. Investigated that the action research project examined using literature circle in the third grade class. And then the next from Sue 20 and 4 had next sexy amount and power of reading classroom. The researcher choose the tech, design, course syllabuses, and set up the written examination after another written exam by applying literature circles. And then next from Rodriguez, 2015 conducted the research of literature circle into enhancing fluency and comprehensive reading. And then from Hamilton, 2013 didactic research examined the influences literature circle on student reading level. And then in the next from Bob Gina in 2014, and then from Daniel 2002, and D and Kroon 2010. I use this quantitative research on this design because the subject are not taking randomly. So I use the subject which are experimental and control group. Principally, I assign the experimental control treatment to intake group and perform the experimental treatment activities with experimental group. For the population and sample, I took 16 students. I used two classes as sample of the study. I take sample using non-random sampling. I use, they were class A and class B. I choose class A as control group and class B as the experimental group. The student number of class A was 13 students, while class B was 13 students. And then the finding, it is found that the value of significant were lower than T table, with this significant value with the significant value to the student with high CLV level was 0.0. The student with intermediate CLE level was 0.0. And for those students with low CLE level was 0.0. It means that the first hypothesis here was rejected. So there is significant difference in the effect of PLC enhancing critical reading toward the student who have high, intermediate, and low critical language awareness in the post-test. And then there is relation among PLC, TRI, and CLE level. The ANOVA saw that significant less than T-table, which inferred that the relation between digital literature circle, technology in the curated instruction, and critical language awareness level is significant. It can be concluded that effect of digital literature circle on the reading critical reading skill depend on the student form ability on DLC and the level of student CLA. Here the summary of the finding. I have read from the first research question, so I won't read to the next finding for number 10. There is no significant, and the finding number 10, there is no significant difference in the effect of DLC enhancing critical reading toward students who have high and low. And then the next is there is no significant toward the student who have intermediate and low. And the fourth, there is no significant difference between pretest and post-test obtained by students who have with high, intermediate, and low in received in the IA techniques. And then the sixth, there is no significant effect TRI enhancing critical reading toward students with high and intermediate CLA. And then the next is towards students who have high in low, and then the next towards students who have intermediate and low. And then the ninth finding is there is significant difference is using DLC or TRI in enhancing critical reading towards students with who have high. And then the next is towards the student who have intermediate. And that's the next finding is there is a significant difference in using TLC or using TRI enhancing critical reading towards student who have low. And then the 12, there is a significant difference effect in the between TLC and TRI technique on the student critical reading skill within critical reading test. Okay, finally, I conclude that there are relation among digital literature circle and technology integrated instruction is significant enhancing critical reading collaborative with critical language awareness with low, intermediate, and low level. And the last, digital literature circle believe outperform than other variable. And then the last is suggestion. The suggestion here to the teacher that critical reading skill by using in order to motivate to make student interested in learning critical reading. And then to the student, pay attention to the teacher's explanation about the lesson and participate in the knowledge of reading, of running critical reading through digital literature circle. And then to the other researcher, I hope to do similar research with similar topic by using full scope and larger population so that the ratio will be more applicable and tertiary level. I think that's all my presentation. Thank you.
Baik, terima kasih. Selanjutnya karena sudah ujian tanya jawab. Penguji masing-masing memberi pertanyaan atau klarifikasi masing-masing 10 menit waktunya. Penguji pertama dipersilakan Profesor Dr. Soekarno MSI. Dipersilakan, Prof.
Terima kasih yang sangat kami hormati dan sangat cendekia Bapak Ketua Dewan Penguji, Bapak Bapak Ibu yang saya hormati dan Saudara Joko Sutrisno. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Prof.
First of all, let me personally congratulate you on the completion of your dissertation draft, Pak Joko Sutrisno.
Thank you.
You have worked very hard, I suppose, to comply with one of the requirements to be a doctor in language education. Wise men say, a good work is the one which is finished. You agree?
Yes, Prof.
And you are able to finish your dissertation draft. So once again, congratulations.
Okay. Thank you, Prof. Thank you.
Well, I have quite a lot of questions and followed by suggestions. Let me directly start with the first due to the limited time. It is about your title, Pak Joko. I have checked with Google that DLC, Digital Literature Circle, is normally practiced with children. Normally practiced with children. Did you treat your college students like children?
No, Prof.
Yes. Yes, please.
Actually, Prof, I found this technique, this Digital Literature Circle, that there are no researchers to conduct this research. So I try to combine between digital and critical literature circle here because there is no previous researcher conducted this technique. And I try to browsing in the internet that DLC used in children.
Yeah.
I studied here that there are different techniques in this on the study prop.
Okay. All right. Yeah. When I checked the table of content as well as chapter 4 and also just now your presentation, your slides, yeah, I could not find any discussion after the, your findings. As we know that discussion, the analysis is a very important part of a dissertation. Yeah, can you give me the reason why?
Yeah.
No discussion.
Actually, bro, in the finding on the my study has combined finding and discussion also.
Yeah, did you read the guideline of the dissertation writing?
Yes.
Frankly speaking?
Yes.
No. Yeah, because chapter 4 should consist of two big things, findings and discussions, right? You cannot integrate them into one part because they are different. And this is the most important part, I think. Yeah. So my suggestion is that you need to complete or to add or to with separated and appropriate or sufficient discussion, your dissertation. You agree, Pak Joko?
Yes, I request for.
Okay, all right. Yeah. You want to say something about yes. this?
Yes.
Okay, you agree?
I have combined in the finding with the our discussion, bro.
Okay, you need to check your the guideline of writing a dissertation one again. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Check check the guidelines. Okay. All right. Yeah. Well, a good dissertation is characterized as having significant theoretical contribution. You wrote in the significance of the study on page 15. Open your dissertation on page 15. Pak Joko. You wrote four theoretical contributions. Is it right? Am I right?
Yes, well.
Yeah, however, all of them are intended to students. Yeah. Are you sure that they are real theoretical contributions? Contribution for students?
I'm sure, Prof.
You are sure?
Yes.
You know what is meant by theoretical contribution? Theoretical yes. contribution.
Yes. Because actually...
Not because. Do you know what is meant by theoretical contribution?
Yes.
What is meant by theoretical contribution?
Theoretical contribution meant that when we conducted a research, we make some contribution in learning process.
Learning process. No, that is pedagogical. That is pedagogical contribution or practical contribution. You need to, recheck what is meant by theoretical contribution, then revise them. One of the things is that how do the contribution or it contribute to the existing theories? Contribution to the existing theories can
yes.
be rejecting, can be modifying, can be strengthening or something. Yeah, not to students. Okay. If it is to students, then it will be a kind of pedagogical contribution. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now, in relation to the novelty of your research, I found that you did not differentiate your research with the previous studies you reviewed. You just display the studies one by one separately without differentiating and synthesizing them to show the distinctive position or novelty of your research. For example, on page 27, 28 of your dissertation, you wrote that Rashidi and Karnades' research is similar to your research without explaining the difference. Do you have any reason for this?
Yes, actually, Prof, my study identifying gap, yes, and the generating question can be regarded as the first as important step in writing my research. And then based on the previous research, the study that there are many researchers conducting the literature circle, but of all of them, there is no digital proof. And then
did you write it in your document? No, not yet. Okay, so revised it. Okay. Now, 1 minute. Oh God. I also found that many references which are quoted in the body of the dissertation are not listed in your bibliography. For example, on page 52, open page 52. Have you found it? Saleh, 2012.
Yes.
And Kufron and Saleh, 2016. And the others. Yeah. They are not listed in your bibliography, right?
Yes.
You have any reason for that?
Actually, my citation prof, I using Mendeley. So I use
using what?
Mendeley. Mendeley platform.
Yeah. The product, the performance is like that. Saleh 2013 on page 52 are not listed in the bibliography.
Yes.
So that is the fact. I don't know. You have said that you have Mendeley program or application,
I will be updated.
Okay.
We need updated on the Mendeley, so we'll appear on the off citation and the reference.
Yeah, most importantly is complete your bibliography. You agree?
Yes, bro.
Okay, all right. Now, the last. Okay, I'm coming to the last. My last suggestion has something to do with the accuracy of your language of writing. There are still so many grammatical mistakes. For example, from the very, very beginning, the second sentence of your background on page one, open page one. Yeah, the second sentence, it reads, the progress that SAF caused the fourth industrial revolution, it is an incomplete sentence, right? And there are still so many others. Please check them all and divide them. Okay. Sorry. Thank you. Yeah, that's all from me. Wish you good luck, Pak Joko. Terima kasih, Bapak Ketua.
Assalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Prof. Farno, boleh sholat dulu, enggak apa-apa.
Oh, nggih, matur nuwun, Prof. Alhamdulillah.
Baik, penguji kedua. Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono, MPD, dipersilakan Prof. Rudi, waktu baik. Maksimal 10 menit.
Baik, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam warahmatullahi.
Yang saya hormati Bapak Ketua Sidang dan Bapak Direktur yang sangat cendikia, Bapak Ibu para penguji yang saya hormati dan juga banggakan, serta Prof. Vendus yang saya banggakan lah ya, tapi tidak tahu ini karyanya membanggakan atau tidak ya. Okay, congratulations ya, because everything you did ya, that's yours ya. Yeah. But of course, I suggested many months ago ya, so you should be able to revise your work ya, yeah, your research result, yeah, your dissertation, yeah. For example, many problems in mechanics, yeah. Many problems in mechanics. You need to revise, yeah, to re-edit, yeah, in order to have a good writing mechanisms, yeah. And also table of contents. I suggested that please, yeah, write a good format of table of contents, yeah, as good as possible, and then see the standard one. And then figures, yeah. Maybe you are still confused, and your figures, your tables, your diagrams, yeah, sometimes you are confused to state which one, yeah. The figure, yeah, in my mind, it is not figure, it is diagram, yeah. While you write figure, but it is not figure, yeah. Okay, Pak Joko, yeah, you should be able to classify which one figure, which one diagram and chart. Okay, and then the next one, for example, what Prof. Karno said that please keep good grammar for your PhD thesis. Yeah, phrase structure, sentence structure, clauses. Yeah. And then citation, yeah, citation style. It's better for you to refer to the newest one. Although now, yeah, in your work, yeah, you have done well, yeah. You have referred to the newest one. And then what else? Discussion. I see that in your discussion, yeah, you didn't discuss, yeah, using the previous studies or theoretical background to support your arguments. Yeah, it's better for you to strengthen your arguments in your discussion by bringing the previous studies and theoretical foundation you have, yeah, in the chapter 2. Yeah, okay, yeah, it is what you should revise. Next to the question, how many previous studies, yeah? How many previous studies did you read or did you keep in your dissertation, Pak Joko?
Yeah, actually I read more than one article, bro.
How many?
More than 100 articles.
100 articles.
I said okay. Hit fast.
Okay, it's okay, good. 100, yeah, 100 article you have read, yes, many articles.
Press.com, yeah.
Okay, so what is the gap? What is the main gap as your starting point to do your research?
Yes. Okay, Prof. My
research gap, or the uniqueness, or the newest, yeah. So it is your starting point, yeah, for your research or the future research. What is the gap?
Okay, the gap. My study identifying gap and generating research question that can be regarded in the first and most important step in writing my dissertation. The gap here in my dissertation is many researcher conduct literature circle, not digital literature circle. So in the teaching reading and critical reading, I conduct the digital literature circle combined with the digital on the field, Prof.
So what is the difference between your research and the previous one?
In the previous one, at only the manual literature circle. So in my study conducting with digital, like in mobile phone, in the application of mobile phone. So while they learning critical reading, they use mobile phone on application by using digital, bro. So it is different.
And then, so what is your novelty from your research? If you see from the gap and then the difference between your research and the previous one.
Yes, actually,
The new thing that you have from your research
that can be enriched from the previous study, Prof.
Huh?
Enriched from the previous study.
No, your research is not just enriching the previous studies. Yeah, it can be maybe a concept, it can be a model, it can be a new techniques, it can be a new approach. Yeah, because digital literacy literature circle is, for example, a method. You compare to the previous one. So the new thing from your research is, well, what's form of your research result? Because it is a PhD dissertation, yeah, PhD thesis. It is not just describing and then you just compare yeah to the previous study yeah and then you said that it is just enriching. No, yeah. What form? So okay. Everybody can say this is yours. This is Pak Joko's finding. This is Pak Joko's product. Yeah, taken from dissertation research. Yeah, this is the main point. Yeah, this is the main point of PhD research. There must be a difference. Yeah, whether it is a concept or a model or approach or technique or strategies, it depends on what the name it is. But there must be something new. Yeah, it is not like undergraduate student thesis. It is not master's degree thesis. It must be different from all level thesis. Yeah, I want to know the new thing from your research. Yeah, it is not just enriching. What? Do you have one or not?
Yes, I have, Prof.
Yeah, what?
Okay. And
did you state yeah your main point, the finding on your PhD thesis in what part?
In intrinsically, yeah, I have and the novelty in my study that's the first one can enrich from the previous study about the literature sample, and then I find the gap from the previous study that I add the previous study with the digital problem.
And what is it? What is the difference that it is your the enrichment yeah of the previous study? Yeah. What is it?
The difference is in literature circle it's only manual bro. In manual study and reading comprehensive. So I try to make some newest concept or technique with the digital bro.
Yeah, I cannot see the newest concept in your research result. Yeah, maybe it is in the form of a diagram or in the form of the flowchart, in the form of what? Yeah, there must be the fact, the result. Yeah, the product. Yes. Yeah, yes, the concept product.
Yes,
because it is not just stated in your conclusion or what pages? Yeah.
There are many study in comparative study that in some PhD thesis that only have gap in the what is it the significant but the
okay that's all because of the time please state yeah your research result in one sentence please state your research result in one sentence
okay.
It can be your maybe it can be your novelty. Yeah, please state in one sentence.
Okay, there is a new theories in critical disc critical language awareness that digital literature circle has new method or new technique in critical reading studies.
Is it yours? Yeah, is digital literature circle yours? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. Terima kasih Pak Direktur.
Baik. Terima kasih Prof. Rudi. Penguji berikutnya Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto Mhum. Dipersilakan Prof. Yan.
Terima kasih. Terima kasih Prof. Agus Nuryatin yang sangat cendekia. Joko Sutrisno ya, Joko Sutrisno itu Inggrisnya Jack Sutrisno ya, Jack Sutrisno ya. Okay, first point is very easy for you to answer. Do you know the meaning of discuss?
Yes.
Yeah, what is it?
Diskusi, bro.
Yeah, diskusi. What is diskusi?
Menjabarkan.
What else?
Menjabarkan, menelaah, menjelaskan.
Menjelaskan, explain. Menjabarkan, elaborate. Kalau discuss?
Mendiskusikan.
Iya, mendiskusikan, betul. Ya, tapi mendiskusikan itu apa? Gitu loh.
Memberi penjelasan secara detail.
Memberi penjelasan itu artinya explain in detail. Ya. saya bacakan saja ya. Anda belum pernah melihat di kampus ini ya. Jadi to discuss itu artinya to write, to speak or write about a subject in detail. Nah ini, especially considering different ideas ya, or opinions related to it. Ya, different ideas. Oke, artinya if you discuss your findings, it means you compare it, you relate your findings with the previous studies. You studied 100 research articles, right? They are actually the benchmarks of your research, right? You have the findings, then you compare your findings with the benchmark itu. Anda di atas previous research or not? If it is not above the previous research, then there is no new findings. There is no novelty. So that's a problem, right? Yeah, Parudi told you, asked you a question about the discussion, and there is no discussion in chapter 4. Yeah, okay, that's a problem, right? Yeah, okay. Even if you say, you claim that there is a discussion, that you did not mention any research paper at all in chapter 4, right? That you did not mention any studies, yeah. Okay, which means that there is no comparison, there is no relations between your study and the previous studies. That's a problem, right? Yeah, okay. Now that is why then Prof. Karno asked you about findings. Okay, and then second point is, do you know the difference between enhancing and enhancement?
Enhancing
means
meningkatkan.
Enhancement means
peningkatan.
Are you enhancing or are you doing some enhancement? Who is enhancing the critical reading? Who is enhancing? You or the teachers?
Me, the teacher.
Me, you or the teacher?
The researcher, bro.
Researcher, yeah. So you taught the students in the classroom.
Yes,
I taught. Yeah. Are you a researcher or a teacher in this case?
Yeah, both of.
Both. Yeah, that's a problem. That's a problem. That's why I can guess the results of your study. It is effective, right? Yeah. Okay. And then, okay. Yeah. Next point is that. Quantitative study or experimental study is a predetermined study, right? Predetermined, yeah. Approach, you are using predetermined approach. You predetermined everything before going to the field and so on, right? Okay, and then if I take a look at the proportion of your dissertation, itu, the proportion of chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, and chapter 5, itu, they are not proportional, right? Yeah, okay. You just give very small number of space, yeah, small amount of space in methodology, whereas methodology is very important in this case, yeah, because this is a predetermined study, yeah. Okay, now, in line with Prof. Rudy and Prof. Carlos' questions, then, it is about your previous studies, yeah. Previous studies, yeah. I also stresses here that you did not put number one. Yeah. Okay, research question number one. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You found it, right? Yeah. How significant is the use of blah blah blah? Okay. How significant is the use of blah, blah, blah? So what is your finding? Is it significant or not? Yes. Yes or no? Yes. So you found that it is significant. So what then? Yeah. You found that that this digital literature circle is significant. Then what does it mean? What is your inference then?
Yeah. At this point, that based on the ANOVA, yeah, ANOVA, the value of significant that lower than T table, bro.
I know, but then what is the implication of this finding?
Yeah, the implication is the effect of teaching by using TLC technique has improvement in enhancing critical reading, Rob.
Okay, so what is the implication of that?
Then using the technology integrated instruction.
Can you suggest the readers to use
TLC?
This, yeah.
Yes.
So did you write that, okay, for teachers, then it is better for you to use digital literature circle because it is effective, something like that, or not? Yes or no?
Yes, Prof. Of course.
Where did you write that?
The study, yes.
Where did you write that?
My study.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Check it again.
I'm okay.
Here you have 13 research questions, right? 13 research questions. But then I want to talk first about research question number 1.3.5. How significant is the interaction? Sorry, yeah. Talking about research question number 13, that is interaction. Yeah, okay. What do you mean by interaction? Yeah, what interacts in this study?
Yeah, actually interaction is ada hubungan sebab akibat berdasarkan apa yang kita berikan kepada mahasiswa melalui apa perlakuan sebuah perlakuan di sini perlakuan
so ada. what interacts?
Interact.
So A and B interacts to one another. So what interacts?
Yeah, interact is
Bukan. Yang berinteraksi itu apa?
Ya, interaksi between the technique and with the CLA, language awareness level. Bro.
Are you sure or not sure?
Yes, I'm
If sure. If you are not sure, because your answer is not convincing. Yeah, your answer is not convincing. Yeah, okay. So meaning it implies that you are not sure, right? Yeah. Okay.
Actually, I'm sure not, Prof, because not I'm not be able to make some good sense.
Begitu. Artinya you admit, right? You admit that you still have to read further about the meaning of interaction. Yeah. Okay. Is there any interaction or not?
Yeah, there is no interaction.
There is no interaction. So if there is no interaction between method and teaching method and materials, yeah. If there is no interaction, then why you claim that the success of your teaching is due to significant digital literature circle, yeah? Kalau tidak ada interaksi, berarti digital link literature circle itu nggak ada maknanya, itu loh.
No, there was interaction in low level, bro. But in high intermediate.
Okay, what did you mean by low level of interaction?
Low level interaction in CLA that the student have low in critical language level have lower value.
Okay, so read methodology again. See the meaning of interaction, right? To improve your dissertation, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus Nuryatin. Yeah. Pass. Yeah.
Baik, makasih Prof. Dan penguji berikutnya Ibu Uli Sri Uli Fitriati SPD MPD PhD. Dipersilakan Bu Uli waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Baik. Terima kasih Bapak Direktur yang saya sangat hormati Pak Joko.
Ibu.
Ya, bisa mendengar suara saya dengan jelas ya?
Yes, it is
okay,
very good.
Baik. Okay. Well, Pak Joko, I'd like to ask you about the findings of your research.
Okay, Ibu.
Well, everyone can read the findings of your research from your abstract. Right?
Yes.
Okay. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 13 13 points of your findings. And it states that all there is no significant difference. There is no significant difference from findings number 1 to up to 13. My question is, so what? If there is no significant difference based on your treatment to control group and experimental group, so what's your interpretation?
Actually, Bu, when I conduct this research, I try to be honestly to make a questionnaire, and then I try to what we call in statistically using SPSS, mm-hmm. but the result is not there is no interaction and significant interaction.
Mm-hmm.
It means that I do not like what my research to conducting this research. If I forced to become there is interaction, it is not not the research, Ibu.
Mm-mm, of course, I absolutely agree with you that you are not allowed to manipulate your data. I agree with you, but you should see the point of my question. Yeah, what do the data mean? Because it relates to Prof. Karno's question or argument that the technique of digital literacy circle is commonly or mostly used for young learners. Don't you think that this is because of the characteristics of that technique, which make it doesn't produce any significant difference in the student's achievement of reading? What do you think?
Yes, Ibu. Actually, mm-hmm. I agree with Prof. Sukarno's statement that digital literature circle was used by applied in children.
Mm-hmm.
But here in my study, it is different, Ibu.
Yeah.
I searching in the Google that there is no the technique that conducting by adults.
Okay.
A digital critical circle in the children not only in the picture, Ibu.
Mm-hmm.
Not using the digital.
Mm.
They most often using the picture. They saw the picture from the children that to discuss the picture. It is very, very different with my technique.
Yeah, okay, stop there, please. I'd like to highlight what you just explained, Pak Joko. You explained several times to us, to the panel of examiner, that digital literature circle research, yeah, you did not find in any research, especially conducted in university level or college students. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, perhaps my statement is like this. Perhaps because this technique, this teaching technique is appropriate for young learners. So that's why, let's say, no other researchers are trying to apply this for university or college students.
Yes.
Okay. Because the characteristics of college students and young learners are different. Well, actually, that's not the focus of my question, Pak Joko. I'm just trying to stimulate you so that you can explain more about the findings, because 13 point here states that no significant difference. So how could your treatment in experimental group help them to improve their critical thinking?
Yes, Ibu.
Mm-hmm.
Can you repeat the question?
Okay, once again. There is no interaction. There is no significant difference. So what will your findings be beneficial for your students?
Yeah. Actually, in all of the research question,
mm-hmm.
not all of the research or not the finding is not significant, mm-hmm. but there is three or more finding is significant.
Mm-hmm.
So in the finding is significant, I try to apply this my research to the student. Mm-hmm. It is a very based on the statistically, it is a very improve their reading, critical reading, Ibu.
Mm-hmm.
So although there is no interaction, but this my research is have value to enhance critical reading toward the student, Ibu.
Yeah, well, you should have discussed about that in discussion section. Unfortunately, you didn't have a discussion section in your dissertation, Pak Joko.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, you discuss about that, your interpretation in discussion section. Now, for further research, for your recommendations, what is your recommendations to other researchers or for reading lecturers in any university, teaching in any university related with your findings?
Yes, to other researchers, let's hope that my study is a very although there is no significant, but it's there is significant effect
in
enhancing critical reading. So for the other researcher, I may suggest that to continue my research or make more completely or make perfect with me from my research.
Excuse me, I don't quite understand. What do you mean? To make more complete, more perfect, what do you mean?
I know that my research is a very lack of, or is it the significant? To do other research, mm-hmm. it is hope that by using this technique, technique the especially in digital literature circle, and best my finding that there is significant effect, but not not in large population, because in my campus is very the newest campus and little the student. So the other researchers can conduct in more larger in the population.
I see. Okay. Next, I think this is a easier question. Yeah. So are you suggesting that digital literature circle used by reading lecturers at university or not?
Yes, Ibu. Because yes. I combine there is moderating variable from critical language awareness. That critical language awareness is branched from CDA, critical discourse analysis that proposed by Fairclough and Van Dijk.
Okay. And another technique, technology integrated instruction. Are you suggesting lecturers to use this technique in their reading classes?
Yeah, actually, when using technology integrated instruction, has doing by many researcher.
Mm-hmm.
Then I just combine with my technique in the literature circle, Ibu.
Okay. And the last one, what have you learned for doing, what have you learned by doing this research for you yourself?
Yeah, pardon me? Sorry.
The benefits, the advantages of doing this kind of research for you yourself, for your professional development.
Okay, Ibu. Actually me, I like using a mobile phone. I have tried to make some application on mobile phone. Then I use Google platform to make this technique. And I try to, make some question answer by using this application. It's I'm very, very happy to doing this. Mm-hmm. And that is the reason that I doing this, conducting this research.
Okay. Well, I'm looking forward to see the tool that you created next time. Thank you, Pak Joko. Terima kasih, Bapak Ketua, Bapak Direktur. Saya kembalikan.
Okay. Hey, terima kasih, Ibu Buli. Penguji berikutnya, Ibu Dr. Dwi Anggani, LPMPD. Dipersilakan, Bu Anggani, waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Oke, terima kasih ya, Bapak Direktur yang saya sangat hormati atas waktu yang diberikan kepada saya. Congratulations to Pak Joko Sutrisno that you have completed your dissertation draft because it is still draft. You have to make a revision on it, ya, based on the suggestion and comments of the other examiners. Yeah. To help you, actually I do agree with all the comment or suggestions from the other examiners, yeah, because it will make your dissertation better. Yeah, I think you can do that, yeah, because you have done everything actually. But in your report, yeah, maybe you forget, yeah, or forgot to write down what you have to do that. To make or to help you, Pak Joko Sutrisno, please in chapter four, yeah, because your questions are many, yeah, 13, you can imagine, yeah, 13. So the readers feel complicated, yeah, complicated, yeah, that apa to get the focus or the main ideas, yeah, of your result, yeah. If you don't mind, please write down the summary, yeah. I mean the summary is not in the form of essay anymore, but in a table, write down one by one research question, and then the result, statistically result, and then the interpretation, yeah, in one table. Can you hear? Can you hear, Pak Joko? Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Jadi in one table, yeah, help the readers so they are able to understand which one is significant, which one is not significant. Because I'm sure you have not only one independent variable, moderate variable, but three. Ya kan? Ya, yang low, apa tadi yang intermediate and then the high. So it is so complicated, yeah, for the readers to understand. It's better if you make the summary in one table. Maybe not all the students in one group, yeah. I mean the result is significant or not significant. Maybe only a part of it, is it right?
Yes.
Mungkin hanya yang low saja, yang tidak signifikan. Mungkin yang lainnya signifikan, gitu loh maksud saya, ya. Jadi biar mudah melihatnya, taruh di sebuah tabel agak besar, one page only, ya. Jadi kolomnya, ya, research question, and then the result statistically. Statistical result, ya, yeah, and then the meaning or interpretation, ya, yeah. Okay, do you understand what I mean?
Yes, I do.
Ya, yeah, jadi nanti gampang melihatnya, Ya kalau begini kan di mana ini, yang ini letaknya di mana ini? Itu agak susah buat saya juga ya. Nah, terus you can discuss based on your table. Ya, based on the table, based on what in the table easily and clearly. Kan gampang akhirnya. Ya, discuss and then link with the previous studies. Ya, satu persatu atau beberapa atau overall link to the previous studies. Katanya kan tidak bisa itu hanya untuk young learners, tapi kenyataannya bagaimana? Yaitu Anda tolak atau terima teori itu, ya. Ya mungkin sebagian enggak benar, Bu. Cuma sebagian ternyata ada yang signifikan, yang bagian low misalkan. Jadi itu discussion-nya itu runtut. Paham maksud Bu Anggeni ya? Ya itu saja. Yang lainnya you can revise because the suggestion and comments from the examiners are good, make it happen, but to help you, I just want to ask you to write down a table, to summarize all the results. Begitu, paham? Ada pertanyaan?
Yeah,
sudah paham ya? Ya sudah. Bu. Kalau sudah paham, ya only that I can say today good luck ya, and I hope you can understand every suggestion and comment, and you are able to make it happen. Okay, thank you.
Thank you
very much. Yeah. Demikian, Bapak Direktur. Terima kasih atas waktunya.
Baik, terima kasih Bu Anggeni. Penguji berikutnya, Ibu Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini, MPD, dipersilakan.
Bu Dwi Rukmini. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, can you hear me all?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yeah. First of all, thank you very much to Professor Agus Nuryatin,
M-Home.
Sorry.
Yes.
Yeah.
Repeat again. M-Home.
M-Home.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
My late husband. For the chance given to me. Yeah, okay. Yeah, gitu dong, ketawa-ketawa dari tadi kok serius semua. Okay. Before I give my questions, suggestion and others, let me congratulate you, Pak Joko. At last, you can sit over there defending your work.
Thank you, Prof.
Alhamdulillah. Yeah. And thanks a lot for all the examiners who give the suggestions, advices, for the comments, yes, for the improvement of Joko's dissertation. Saya juga terima kasih loh, nanti kamu juga. Okay, and then for your novelty, I think I can help you to find your novelty. One of them is that you can prove that digital apa?
Literature circle, bro.
Yeah, digital literature circle, which, okay, in the past considered to be useful only for young learners, you can prove that. It can also be used for adult. Itu satu. Lainnya banyak. Ya. We can meet and discuss on that. Yes. In your research, you involve language awareness. Okay, why so? What's the role of language awareness in your study? You may use Bahasa Indonesia if you cannot answer in Bahasa Inggris. Yeah. Please.
Critical language awareness mempunyai
awareness
mempunyai karakteristik pada bagian bab akhir itu, Prof. Jadi akan berdampak pada cognitive level student, then social level student, and then the last for affective level student based on Fairclough theory.
Jadi itu mungkin yang kedua. Ya kan? Ya, alon-alon. Okay, let me help you. Nggak usah khawatir. Ya. Ya. So you actually, when answering the questions of the examiner, you may not say, no, there is no interaction in all variables at all. Padahal kan ada yang ada interaksinya kan. Tapi kok Anda, no, not at all, for all. Gitu kan? By German, ya. Dan gitu dong. Sekarang, on page 83, you use a short form of something, which is SAT. Apa tuh, Wi? Can you explain, please, SAT? 83, halaman 83. Buka silok, deret. Come on. Duit ini lho, kok duit Anggani? Kok nggak ada rupaku ya?
SAT.
Ya, SAT.
SAT is the website model, Prof. To, what is it? It is to conduct the standardized test critical thinking, Prof.
Oh, I see.
Yes. When your student has good in critical reading, they automatically have good in critical thinking, Prof. So to make the standard test of the SAT critical reading, the student can use the website of model SAT critical reading practice test, Prof.
Okay. That's the application.
Yes, application.
Okay.
Website platform.
Nah, ini kok iso jelaske? All right. Now, in methodology, you wrote instrument that you didn't have control of the instrument. Yeah. Could you please add that the instruments of your study can be found on the in the appendix page la 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 la. Can you add that? Bisa ditambahkan?
Nggih.
Ditambahkan enggak? Bagi kok rupaku ra ketok iki. Yes. Ya, jadi ditambahkan ya bahwa instrumen dalam studi Anda, study in your research, yeah, can be found in the appendix exactly on page gitu ya. If you check the grammar using Grammarly Advanced and also plagiarism, udah dicek plagiarismenya berapa. Terus itu sudah dicek belum?
Yes, I have checked it in Turnitin, Bro.
Bagus. Plagiarism-nya berapa?
About 80-19%.
Good. And then Grammarly Advanced belum karena banyak sekali grammar yang salah. Ya, nanti dicek lagi ya. Terus di revise, oke? Okay? Itu ya.
Yes, Prof.
Grammarnya masih banyak yang salah. There are clauses having no subject, some having no. Okay. Yeah, it is. They are not. What's that? A complete clause. Yeah. Iman-iman kan? Ya. Yeah. Nanti dikoreksi ya. And okay, thank you very much, Bu Anggani, for helping this guy in okay giving the discussion or providing the discussion in chapter 4, that is making a table so that you can easily see. You may add the interaction, whether there is interaction or not. Matur sangat nuwun Bu Anggani, you help a lot. Yes. And then your pronunciation. Maso estelu pronunciation iki cek payah. Coba Anda bilang ya. Judul apa?
Title.
Title, tapi Anda bilang title. Terus lebih gede, lebih besar.
Yes, Prof.
Large, lebih besar apa? Large.
Kalau large. Lebih,
larger.
Large.
Ya, larger.
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 Ya, larger. Awareness, not awareness. Awareness, ya. Ujian. Menguji.
Yes. Examine.
Examine.
Okay.
Okay, examine.
Examine.
Tiga kali, examine.
Examine.
Lagi.
Examine.
Lagi.
Examine.
Yeah, thank you. Seems like that you do not know the difference between including and consisting. Kalau including itu beberapa, misalnya ya. The examiners of your open examination are first, second, third, terus habis itu etc. Kalau consisting of itu complete. Ya. Itu bedanya. Kalau consisting itu complete, kalau including enggak complete enggak apa-apa, tiga aja terus etc. Itu ya. Thanks a lot Mr. Director of PPS. Hey. That's all from me.
Terima kasih, Prof. Semantik Dwi Rukmini. Yes. Di situ ada padanya semantik Dwi Rukmini.
Yang nambahin mesti direktur ini.
Baik.
Saya enggak nambahin.
Dengan demikian, pertanyaan dan jawaban sudah selesai.
Ketua penguji menunda ujian untuk memberikan waktu kepada para penguji melaksanakan rapat yudisium.
Untuk memberikan waktu kepada tim penguji dalam menentukan hasil ujian. Dengan ini ujian promosi doktor atas nama Saudara Joko Sutrisno SPD MPD dinyatakan ditunda.
Rapat yudisium dipimpin oleh Ketua Penguji. Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan dilanjutkan kembali. Ketua penguji membuka kembali ujian promosi doktor pendidikan.
Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Saudara Joko Sutrisno, SPD MPD, dinyatakan dibuka kembali. Selanjutnya saya baca berita acara ujian disertasi tahap 2. Pada hari ini Selasa tanggal 1 bulan Desember tahun 2020 di Pascasarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, UNES, telah diselenggarakan ujian disertasi tahap 2 atas nama Joko Sutrisno, SPD, MPD pada program studi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa S3 Pascasarjana UNES dengan disertasi yang berjudul Enhancing Critical Reading Throughout Digital Literature Cycle and Technology Integrated Instruction Technique to Students with High Intermediate and Low Critical Language Awareness Level. Setelah dilaksanakan ujian dan dilaksanakan rapat penguji, keputusan tim penguji menyatakan bahwa Joko Sutrisno, SPD, MPD dinyatakan lulus sebagai doktor pendidikan. Dr. Joko Sutrisno, MPD adalah doktor ke-551 lulusan UNES atau doktor ke-108 lulusan Prodi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa S3 Pascasarjana UNES dengan masa studi 5 tahun 3 bulan. Karya ilmiah disertasi diberi penghargaan dengan nilai A sehingga IPK 3,72. Hasil akhir ujian promosi doktor pendidikan dengan predikat kelulusan sangat memuaskan. Sekretaris penguji, Profesor Dr. Agus Nuratin Ambum. Pembacaan selesai.
Ketua penguji mempersilahkan promotor untuk menyampaikan pesan dan kesan.
Promotor dipersilahkan menyampaikan kesan dan pesan.
Yeah, thank you very much for the director. Okay, who give me a chance to give kesan dan pesan untuk dokter baru. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Pertama-tama saya ucapkan kepada dokter baru, congratulations that at last you can have your doctorate degree.
Alhamdulillah, Prof. Thank you, Prof.
Welcome. Yeah. Kesan dan pesan. When I first met Joko, I got an impression that this guy has a very low self-confidence. Benar enggak? Kayaknya enggak percaya diri kan? Ayo, ngaku. Iya kan? But on and on, he's okay. He has been showing the improvement. Ya kan? Ya. Jadi ketidakpercayaan dirinya semakin berkurang dan berkurang. Ya. This also, okay, can also be learned when having many consultations with me online and face to face, and also with Ibu Anggani, I'm sure, karena kalau ketemu dengan Bu Anggani kita selalu ngomong Jokowi piye to, yeah, because I know when you okay if you had comment, suggestion, yes, for the improvement of your dissertation, yes, you note down everything. But it is, it seems that it is hard for you to to fix in such a way so that the previous meanings and the following meaning, okay, after being inserted with the suggestion, yeah, okay, will not match each other, and then you write a new one, kayak gitu kan. Jadi kalau dikasih komentar daripada ngepas-ngepasnya anyar maning gitu kan, saya sampai bingung deh, tapi akhirnya selesai, saya puas sekali ya. Apalagi mendengar furthermore when hearing that you had been stopped teaching in your institution, is that right? Sudah diberhentikan dari institusinya kan? Itu sedih banget dan saya ikut sedih, tetapi Anda tetap semangat. That's great. Itu bagus. Ya, yeah, many problem okay have been happening during your okay study. Not just that. 5 atau 7 hari sebelum Anda ujian, you told me that Anda diuji banget oleh Allah. That is when his brother who live in Surakarta has got brain cancer and became blind. Ya kan? Itu berat banget nih. Dan Anda bisa, saya bilang Anda harus bisa memisahkan itu. Dan ini Anda sudah dinyatakan lulus. Sekarang Anda bisa membantu adik Anda fully. Ya. Itu adalah suatu kehebatan Anda. Kalau orang hanya melihat dari sisi negatifnya, saya melihat dari sisi positifnya, because you told me everything, and I'm sure Bu Anggani also has been told by you. Sudah diceritakan pada Bu Anggani? Belum ya, mungkin cuma sama saya. Ya. Pak Joko, Pak Dr. Joko, aduh, lali doktornya ya, nggak apa-apa. Ini adalah awal dari Anda nanti melamar pekerjaan baru mungkin, dan awal untuk berprestasi. Tapi sebelum itu, Anda harus merevisi dan menunjukkan kepada semuanya, particularly the examiners, that your dissertation ya, pantas untuk ditaruh di perpustakaan. Apalagi saya tanda tangan sebagai promotor. Jangan disia-siakan ya. Oke. Okay. Selamat. Thank sukses. You. Tawakal. Good luck. Oh iya, saya juga memberi selamat kepada ibu Anda. Ketika Anda mengatakan bahwa Simbo sebetulnya kepengen hadir, tetapi harus menunggu saudara saya, nah, gitu kan? Itu saya betul-betul terharu sekali, tetapi saya tidak akan nangis. Dan saya tidak mudah menangis. Menangis saya di hati. Oke, okay. Semoga adik cepat sembuh, Anda sukses, keluarga senang, dan kita semua senang. Ya, yeah. That's all from me. Thank you very much. Wish you good luck. Ya.
Yeah. Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Joko Sutrisno MBD ditutup oleh Ketua Penguji.
Baik. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Dan dengan seizin Bapak, Ibu, serta hadirin sekalian, ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Joko Sutrisno MPD secara resmi saya nyatakan ditutup. Terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Upacara selesai dilanjutkan dengan pemberian ucapan selamat. Ucapan selamat diawali dari Ketua Penguji.
Saudara Dr. Joko Sutino, MPD, saya ucapkan selamat. Hari ini saudara sudah resmi menyandang gelar doktor.
Terima kasih, Prof.
Selamat juga pada keluarga semuanya, dan mudah-mudahan gelar doktor ini menambah berkah bagi Mas Joko Trisno, keluarga, dan pihak-pihak yang lain. Ya, tanggung jawab tentu makin bertambah, tapi mudah-mudahan justru dengan gelar ini, saudara makin bisa berperan dalam meningkatkan kualitas hidup manusia secara umum. Terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Soekarno, MSI.
Pak Joko Sutrisno.
Oke, Bro.
Selamat, alhamdulillah selesai. Hanya tinggal satu langkah lagi, revisi sedikit, ya. Moga-moga semuanya lancar, sukses, menambah kebahagiaan Pak Joko Sutrisno beserta keluarga. Moga kita menjadi manfaat dan barokah.
Amin.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono, MPD.
Ya, baik, terima kasih. Selamat dan sukses Pak Joko ya. Keep the spirit of learning to get the betterment, oke?
Okay? Bismillah.
Ya, oke, okay, sukses.
Jadi awal.
Silakan diperbaiki, direvisi sebaik mungkin sesuai dengan format standar dan tata tulis yang lainnya ya. Kami tunggu, saya tunggu. Terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto, M.Hum.
Ya, terima kasih. Congratulations saja untuk Joko Sutrisno. Jangan Joko terus ya. Ya, jangan Joko terus ya. Oke, okay, ya, maju terus, pantang mundur ya, jangan menyerah ya. Oke, okay, bahwa kemampuannya itu kemampuan seseorang kan tidak harus puncak ya, tidak harus segalanya, tapi ada hal-hal lain yang bisa mendukung masa depan ya. Oke. Okay. Selamat saja dan maju terus, pantang mundur juga. Ya. Terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh Ibu Sri Wuli Fitriati, SPD, MPD, PhD.
Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Selamat Bapak Dr. Joko Sutrisno. I'm happy for you. Mudah-mudahan saya bisa menemukan dan membaca karya publikasi Pak Joko selanjutnya, baik itu berupa monograf atau buku teks, artinya saya sangat mengharapkan ada kelanjutan dari disertasi Pak Joko. Syukur-syukur berkolaborasi dengan Prodi Magister Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris UNES.
Insyaallah mudah-mudahan.
Selamat Pak Dr. Joko Sutrisno. Salam buat istri dan keluarga. Terima kasih Mbak Ani.
Dilanjutkan oleh Dr. Dwi Anggani, LB, MPD.
Nah, terima kasih waktunya. Selamat sekali lagi kepada Dr. Joko Sutrisno. Ibaratnya saya itu seorang ibu yang mendampingi selama ini, ya. Dan apa ya, terharu saya. Soalnya Pak Joko sudah bisa lulus dengan lancar, ya. Dengan perjuangan yang berat ya, dengan apa struggle, dengan keadaan yang tidak mengenakkan di belakangnya, tapi bisa lolos akhirnya. Jadi saya ikut bergembira kali ini ya, karena bisa mengantarkan, mendampingi Pak Joko. Terima kasih atas perjuangannya. Salam untuk keluarga ya, sampai ketemu.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini, MPD.
memberi congratulations lagi. Alright. Pak Dr. Joko Sutrisno. Ya. Selamat. You have done your great job. Selamat untuk semuanya. Dan saya tunggu bukti dari keprofesionalisme Anda. Ya. Yeah.
Serta Bapak Ibu tamu undangan, monggo dipersilahkan memberikan ucapan selamat.
Tutup ya, Mbak. Mbak, tak tutup ya.
Selamat Pak Joko ya. Sukses.
Depo.
Ya, terima kasih semuanya.
Kemudi. Assalamualaikum.
Selamat Pak Joko.
Selamat Mas Joko.
Salam dari Lampung.
Ini teman